Hello and welcome to a product update on the two new families, VAX and FMX. I will start to explain the difference between these new series and why new product series are necessary. To close the gap in our portfolio, we have to extend our product range by low resistance value parts or in small sizes. To explain you where the differentiation between this product family is, I would like to explain you this diagram. Most of you know the product BVF, which is already in series production, which is at the moment in 1 milliohm and 1.5 milliohm available. FMX series, we have three different sizes actually. At the moment, we just work on FMP 2010 size and FMK 1206 size. Both started at 1.5 milliohm up to 6 milliohm. You may ask, why not a 1 milliohm in this two version? The reason is a technical reason. The resistance foil will be too thick, so we cannot produce a 1 milliohm version in our production in this technology. That's the major reason why we start with a new manufacturing technology of the VAF series. We call it VAF series since the German word is Walzplattieren. It's a roll cladding process. The 12-13 size, which is the same like BVF, starts at 0.3 milliohm and end up at 1 milliohm. At the moment, 0.5 and 1 milliohm is available. The VAK 1206, the K is like BMK, CMK, SMK, starts or end up with 2 milliohm. At the moment, we have just 0.5 and 1 milliohm available, and we have a certain projects where really the 0.5 and 1 milliohm is used. So the VAP, at the moment, we have not started, but perhaps someone is looking for such a resistor and we can produce it easily. I will start with the VAF series. The new process at this part is the technical process of roll cladding. We provide the copper, or we provide, let's say, the manganese or the threonine to a third company. We have a copper strip and the manganese strip, and these were rolled cladded together under high pressure. It's a cold rolling process, and both strips will be very hard or very stable connected to each other. This company also make the grooves into the strip material, which will be necessary to have the terminals later on. I think you can see this on the picture on the right-hand side. After this process, the strip material goes to our pungency. The same process like we do with the Isarweld product. We will start with a multiple tool, which will punch 9 pieces per stroke. Just for a better understanding the roll cladding process, we have a copper strip and a manganese strip, and both were pressed together with a rolling process, and there will be a connection between two materials, which will be very stable and very fixed, even due to very high temperature cycle. We already tested this in our laboratory. After we mill the groove into it, you can see the two terminals. Unfortunately, the colors have to be the other way around. Of course, there should be not a groove into the manganese, the groove should be into the copper. All following production steps are similar to Isarweld process. This is the production flow. We start with the copper belt and the resistance belt. Then we have the roll cladding, the grooving and of the milling of the grooves. And after that, the punching process, And then we have the cleaning, stabilization, trimming, and packaging machine. So after we got the material, it's the same process like Isabel. New product here, BAF. F, it's the size is 12-13, the same size like BVF. As I explained, we cannot make the 0.5 milliohm. So the first project is, of course, BAF in a size or resistance value 0.5, which we already made samples and it's already in qualification process. We have to plan to make 2010 and 12 or 6 size 2. This is the VAK, it's in size 1206. Up to now, we haven't had any parts in this low resistance value and this size. BMK end up at 5 milliohm, and now we have an FMK between 1.5 and 5 milliohm, and lower values, we use the VAK. The same process like VAF, and then we have a trimming, and we will supply this part in 1% tolerance too. First parts were checked in our laboratory. You see the components after the grooving, or we mill the grooving. The grooves, you see that the terminals are very precise. So we have a very high a very high precision of the geometry and the terminals of this part. First projects, for instance, is an IGBT half bridge for electrical vehicle inverters for high voltage. For this is 500 microohm, 1 milliohm and 1.5 milliohm. They already use the 1 milliohm version, not of VAF, they use it of BVF. The SOP is not in 22, it's next year. And we already started and we are close to finish the AEC-Q200 qualification. B and C samples already supplied to certain customers. We started with B samples even in January this year. Further applications could be high current application for the automotive market, frequency inverters, power modules, inverters, white goods, and of course, air conditioning system. Everywhere where very low resistance value is needed. Technical unique selling points, for instance, is to have a smaller part to reduce the overall cost and the size on the PC, a TCR optimized part, and very low parasitic effects or thermoelectric. You will see later on that we really have very good long-term stability for this part. Something about the roadmap. We will also introduce this into our data sheet. There's one part missing at the moment. It is a VAK set, 0.5 milliohm. It will include into the new data sheet and the parts will be available beginning of next year. These samples are already available. The qualification of the VAF and VAK is already started and will be finished in November, December this year. Ramp up will be in second quarter 2021. So latest news on the FMX series, which was already introduced at the beginning of last year. We are a little bit ahead with this product family compared to VAF. This is more an ISA plan process. And as you can see, the resistance range is from 1.5 to 6 milliohm. We cannot produce a 10 milliohm or 25 milliohm or even 50 milliohm or an 0.5 milliohm. We have an excellent TCR and the other values are pretty good, so the part can even use for all kind of automotive application where a high current has to be measured. The data sheets are available. We have a final version from the FMK. Since this is already a serious product, The ACQ200 qualification is ready. FMP and FMS is a preliminary version. We have not a major focus of the FMS 2512 series, since, as you may know, we have a parallel product line BVT, which already starts with 0.3 to 5 milliohm in the same size, which is used at the moment in very, very high quantities. So we have the following technical parameters for this part, which you already can find in the current valid data sheets. Application are current sensors, LED lamps, and we have a project in Asia for USB chargers and, for instance, car audio amplifiers. For the competitors, there's just an overview which competitors have similar parts. It's just to give you an information that there are really competitors in the market who have parts in this resistance range. If you need further information, you can contact us. We have made tests in laboratory with the competitor's part. We can give you information about it. We have the data sheets available, sometimes samples. So there are a lot of information available. If you have to discuss the advantages or disadvantages of the competitor's part with your customer. The roadmap for FMX series shows a couple of more already existing resistance values, especially the 5 milliohm version FMK-V is finished and provided to the customer. We use the same ordering code with a dash M or dash V like for Isarwelt parts. M for manganine, V for noventine, and Z for serenine. It's absolutely similar to Isarwelt. And at the moment we introduce new values, it depends a little bit on the requirements. If there is a new interesting project, we start with a new assistance value. The next milestones are further ACQ200 qualifications, and if we have potential projects, we can provide samples and can start with further qualification on new values. This is the ACQ200 qualification for the 5 milliohm version. It's completed, and as you can see on the right hand side, really measured on the part itself, 2000 hours at 140 degrees, there's really an excellent long-term stability. So the drift is far below 0.25%. This is really excellent. Okay, thank you for your attention.